Before we talk about how these normative ethics, deontology, teleology, moral relativism, before we talk about the implications of all these beliefs and views about ethics in adult education, let's talk about the other types of ethical theories or standards. All along, we've been dealing with normative ethics. There's another category of ethics that is called descriptive ethics. Then there's also another category or type of ethics that is called applied ethics. Descriptive ethics studies ethical practices across different cultures. The main goal of descriptive ethics is not to prescribe ethical standards, but it's just about to study different ethical practices across different cultures. It is concerned more about comparative analysis of moral standards across different cultures and groups of people. The goal here is to offer a description of ethical standards from an observer's point of view, from an outsider's point of view. Now, this is very important in adult education practice. Why? Because we deal with different people. We deal with people coming from different cultures. So understanding different cultural backgrounds of the people that we deal with. By the way, we always say adult learners are a mixed bag. Why? Because in terms of value judgments, in terms of ethics, they have different beliefs. They are coming from different cultures, different organizations, different backgrounds, different histories. They may have different perspectives about ethics and value judgments. So we must understand from an outsider's point of view or an observer's point of view so that we'll be able to understand how ethics, how value judgments affect our learners. Without that understanding, there will be conflict and adult education will fail. But if we understand the application of these ethical standards or moral values, moral judgments, then we'll make sure that there are no conflicts involved, then we'll make sure that our programs will be successful. And we will see how ethics and moral values help us in practice, help us in the field of adult education in terms of designing our programs, in terms of assessing learners' needs, content building or evaluating programs, in terms of the implementation of adult education activities and programs on the ground. As I said, descriptive ethics does not seek to offer prescriptive guidelines for behavior, but it only helps to study people's beliefs about morality. Then there's another category that is applied ethics. Applied ethics is the branch of ethics concerned with how to apply ethical standards in real life. We must not talk about ethics in terms of beliefs and theorizing, philosophizing, asking questions that have no answers. If we are talking about moral rules and regulations, then we must formulate those rules and regulations and put them in, enforce them into action. Applied ethics defines ethical guidelines and expectations in various fields. There's a branch of medical ethics, legal ethics, social ethics, research ethics, educational ethics, etc., etc. Applied ethics is essential in determining public policy. Why this is important? Because we have different people coming from different backgrounds with different belief systems concerning morality. But we must have a standard somewhere, somehow. And then when we are enforcing this standard, we are talking about applied ethics. We are now applying ethics into action. Applied ethics extends application of ethical standards beyond human rights. We can talk about human rights, define what human rights are, stipulate what human rights are, make laws about human rights. But applied ethics goes beyond human rights. It also looks into issues like animal rights, rules about environmental management, organizational ethics, organizational culture. So we are talking about setting rules of conduct. If it is in an organization, setting rules of conduct in an organization. If it is in a community, setting rules of conduct in that community. If it is at an institution, setting the rules of conduct at that institution. That is the field of applied ethics. Then there's another yet important category about axiology or in axiology, that is aesthetics. Aesthetics is that branch that deals with the appreciation of beauty, the creation of beauty. Why? Because education must help us to gel with our environment, to appreciate the natural environment, to appreciate beauty, to enhance the beauty of life. We are talking about things like art, music, and culture. Different cultures and environments influence people's appreciation of beauty and art in different ways. Different cultures and environments also shape the way people express themselves. That is in art form, maybe music, poetry, crafty, etc., etc. This appreciation influences people's learning patterns. That's why it is a concern in adult education. Because as people try to conform to their perceptions of beauty, as they try to conform to the appreciation or the creation of beauty, as they try to gel with the environment, learning or education must have a role in all that. So educational programs reinforce or order these perceptions about beauty. The goal of adult education is therefore to study and understand forms of beauty in different cultural settings and help to transmit the knowledge about beauty and the skills and habits to conform or conserve this beauty. Thus, there is a close connection between values or ethics and beauty. For example, when there are rules preventing the cutting down of trees in a community, what do you think that is? That is aesthetics. We want to preserve the nature, the natural environment as it is. We want to preserve natural resources. There's also a close connection between values or axiology and reality. There's also a close connection between values and knowledge. Why? Because all these branches or categories contribute to the beauty of life. That is aesthetics for you. So what is the importance of all this theory about values and ethics and beauty in adult education? Yes, we are asking philosophical questions here and there, but what is the implication of all that in adult education practice specifically? Beliefs about ethical standards, morals, values affect adult education in so many ways or in different ways. The conduct of teaching and learning, the relations and interactions of facilitators and learners, the conduct of adult education practitioners in the communities or at institutions must conform to certain behavioral standards or to ethical standards. Most importantly, ethical guidelines help to set the path for behavior to avoid several pitfalls that can occur in the field. Ethical considerations in adult education practice reduce chances of conflict between educators and educatees. Various theories explored help us to understand different views from which value judgments about the norms of practice are made. It's either they are made from an absolutist point of view, it's either they are made from a relativist point of view, it's either they are made from a teleological point of view or from a deontological point of view. So all these theories or beliefs about ethical standards, about morality, shape our understanding of morality as adult educators. These theories help us to understand how people make their moral judgments or moral decisions, so that when we are going into the community or into organizations or institutions, we know the ethical standards or belief systems, systems of norms and values that govern community or society. So that as adult educators, we may be able to have an impact. We can make an impact in that target group. For example, humanism presupposes a universalist and inherent ethical and sometimes a relativist ethical view, which affirms or conforms to the dignity of all persons, to the equality of all human beings. It means all people are equal and must be treated the same. It means we must not impose on people what they should learn and how they should learn. The people must make their own choices about their educational goals. The people must be able to evaluate their own educational values, because we are placing their dignity and ability to make their own choices at the top. So this pluralist view of ethics in humanism education supports that ethics depend on the socio-cultural, historical, or personal circumstances. Look now how we are trying to knit those theories together. The universalist theory, the relativist theory, and the subjectivist theory. With this ethical stance, humanists believe that all educational activities for adults should lead to self-fulfillment and realization of personal goals and human interests. So nobody should be above another. Nobody should impose on others. People must make their own free choices. The ethical belief of humanists is that all humans are equal and they must be accorded respect and dignity. Thus, teaching and learning methods must be participatory. That is where participatory learning or self-directed learning comes into play, because we want to create a balanced relationship between teachers and learners. We want to create a balance between adult education and the environment. Yes. Then behaviorists hold a realist moral view. Remember when we talked about moral realism, behaviorists hold a realist moral view towards adult education. They believe that moral judgments based on the cognitive processes, based on character, based on virtue, on personal circumstances, do not play a role in determining ethical standards in adult education. Rules of conduct are determined by the environment in which education is conducted. So behaviorists behave a moral realist approach in all endeavors, and they believe that moral conduct of the educators and educatees is governed by specified rules. And these rules contribute to the changes in behavior. And these changes in behavior are the goals of adult education. That is in the behaviorist sense. Then what about liberalists? Liberalists are those people who believe in cognitive development, that is development of mind. They believe that education should develop the thinking capacity of human beings. So they may hold an absolutist belief system concerning moral judgments or values. Liberalists believe that to develop people with great intellectual powers, the education should be based on higher order moral values. This is the reason why is so closely linked or knit together with religion, because religious perspectives about moral values are more oriented towards absolutism. The influence of religious thought in liberalism plays a major drive towards absolutism and biblical virtues. Remember when I was talking about virtues, this means that liberalism appeals to Christian values as commandments given by God. And these commandments sometimes are viewed as unchangeable. Thus, education should produce highly cultured, virtuous people with great powers, people with great influence in the world, leaders, right? I think it's now being clear what we are dealing with, what we are talking about. Let me conclude with the progressivist stance concerning moral judgments or moral values. The progressivist adult education appeals to pragmatic ethical standards. The progressivists have a pragmatic orientation to moral values. This means that progressivists want to find, or they try to find, balance between what works and what do not work. By that, we are now talking about
things like education 5.0, if we are theorizing and philosophizing, asking questions about ethics and moral judgments, then we must come to a point where we create those values, those rules, those laws, and enforce them into practice. Without that, we haven't transformed society, as the progressivists say. Because remember, the goal of progressive education is transforming society through production. Education with production. Progressivists appeal more to applied ethics, rules, setting rules or prescribing rules that actually work in real life. Right, today I've been talking more of these ologies and isms, big words, ontology, teleology. But what we are simply saying is that, what are the belief systems about moral values? How do moral judgments, moral decisions, ethical standards, or beliefs about these ethics affect the practice of adult education? Thank you. Meet again in the next video presentation.